Rams won yesterday, I'm in a good mood. Excited about tonight, playing on MLK Day. It's gonna be a good day.
How are you feeling when you heard about the timeline for Lonzo?
It's unfortunate. He's starting to play really good basketball. So I know he's emotionally devastated right now. I think he was in a really good groove, and we'll get through it, and he'll come back, and we'll work. But it's gonna be another thing.
What has he said to you, and how is he? You said emotionally devastated.
Well, he hasn't said much. He's just, you could tell his body language, he's down. You know what I mean? He was really in a good place and competing and figuring some things out. So, and I think he knows how much we need him. And I think he feels a big responsibility to our team having success, which he should. So, I haven't had a chance to talk to him today, but yesterday he was pretty down.
There's a silver lining to the timing, just knowing that you're expecting to get Rondo and LeBron, some of those other playmakers back soon.
We can't wait to get those guys back. But even with them back, we're really gonna miss what Zoe's been doing for us and the progress that he's made up to date so far. This is as much as you're gonna see Rondo playing basketball today. We don't play again until Thursday. It just makes more sense to give him a couple extra days.
Personnel-wise, you mentioned that Caruso, you guys would probably call him up.
Yeah.
Is there more that needs to be done? I know that's a Rob or Magic question, but do you think to get through these 4 to 6 weeks, do
you need
a guy?
Yeah, I mean, that's not really. I love our team. We're going to get Brandon back at point guard, so we'll keep doing what we do. And I know that Rob and Magic are working, looking for other, options of possibilities. What that is, I don't know. If we don't do anything, that's fine, too. We go out there and we find a way with our guys that have been here working their tails off for us.
Do you feel like when LeBron comes back and then when even Zoe comes back, do you feel like you know what you have? Do you feel like you know what this team can be?
We know what we have. We just, unfortunately, haven't been able to get a lot of time with it. Mm-hmm. So, we're going to continue to work and continue to make progress. But as we get healthy and we get further down the season, it's going to be a lot more like cramming for a final, having to really take some giant steps as a team once we get healthy.
What's LeBron done over the last few days?
Came in yesterday, had a get what you need day, so he did. He got out here on the court, got up and down a little bit, did all our shooting, some 5-on-0 non-contact stuff, and then he went and got treatment, and Rondo stayed out here in the scrimmage with some of the guys.
How much practice do you think he needs before he would be
His will be more based on health. You know what I mean? He's one of those players. You'd like to get guys at least a full day practice and whatnot, and we will. We'll manipulate the practice schedule however we need to get him playing against some people. But I would imagine once he feels healthy enough to go, that he'll go.
Luke, is Rondo cleared for 5-on-5?
Yeah. He played some yesterday.
What's the final step for him to be able to play? You hear you can do full contact. What's next?
Well, it's getting comfortable with it again. To me, watching him play yesterday, he still naturally tries to protect it a little bit. Which anytime you're coming back from an injury, it's a big thing. You gotta get hit a couple times. If it's an ankle, you gotta trust it, and you're turning a corner. To do that is just to get more reps and more time. So just playing basketball, really.
Is the starting lineup going to be Brandon at point guard, Josh up to the starters, or have you?
There's been some debate about that. Brandon's going to be our starting point, and we're still just debating a little bit with who the other starter will be.
Speed's
in the discussion, yeah.
Did you
like going all the way back to Christmas and the day after, did you know then or understand then that LeBron was going to be out a while? Did you, like, going all the way back to Christmas, LeBron gets hurt, and the next day he has Zama. Did you know then or understand then that he was going to be out a month, that you would be without him this whole time?
I don't really, we plan for it. You know, you always, in my experience, you always plan for the worst, hope for the best. So we're not going to play the next week expecting that Bron's going to be back in 7 days. We're gonna plan and practice and get after it. Like, we're not going to have him for a while. And hopefully he gets back within a couple days. But, you know, that's just kind of our mindset when anyone gets hurt.
So in the early days, when we didn't know that he was going to be out a long time, you didn't spend any time like looking over your shoulder or looking off to the side like, is he ready today? Is today the day?
No, that's what the trainers and doctors are for. They let us know when people can play and when they can't. So, you know, we have a ton on our plate, and we got guys that are working, that are trying to help us win. So that's where our focus as a coaching staff stays.